He was not guilty of insurrection. He was only guilty of opening blinded eyes. He was only guilty of unstopping deaf ears. He was only guilty of multiplying fish and loaves and feeding a hungry multitude. But as I ask the question, why are you treating my Lord in this fashion? I hear the words of the prophet Isaiah rolling from 700 years of prophecy out of that 53rd chapter of his book, saying he's not guilty for anything that he's done, but he is wounded for our transgression, bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace is upon him, and it is with his stripes that we are healed. They whipped his back to heal your backache. They nailed his hand, stretched his arms in order to heal your hands and heal your arm condition. They nailed his feet to take care of the condition in your legs and in your swelling ankles. Oh, glory to God. Well, why did they put a crown of 72 thorns on his head? Because most of our problems somehow end up in the head. They originate in the head. 72 thorns to take care of your migraine headache. 72 thorns to take care of your ear, eye, nose, and throat condition. 72 thorns to take care of your psychosomatic illnesses. He was wounded for our transgression and bruised for our iniquity. But as he hung on the cross, bearing in his body all of our sin and all of our disease, the worst suffering that he could ever have inflicted on him, he looked into heaven, and heaven blacked out. But before it blacked out, he saw the Father turn his back on him, and he said, "Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, my God, why have thou forsaken me?" Oh, glory to God. God had to turn his back on Jesus, because when he looked on the cross, he couldn't see Jesus, because he saw our sin. He saw your glory. He saw your alcoholism. He saw your cancer. He saw your AIDS. He saw all of our sin and all of our diseases hanging on Jesus. And when he saw it covered with our sin, he had to turn his back. But my God hung out there, way out on Calvary, and he died. And said, "Who is this that cometh from Edom, when God cometh home from Bozrah, traveling in the greatness of his strength, traveling and treading the winepress alone?" He said, "I looked and there was none to help, so with my own arm I brought salvation unto me." He did it all by himself. Refused to bow down when Satan told him that I'll give you the kingdom of the world. He refused when the devil said, "Turn the stone into bread." But look, we got him now. He's hanging on Calvary, and I just heard him ask the Father, "Why have you forsaken me?" Demons were rejoicing, and the saints were troubled, but he died out there by himself. And finally, when he said, "Father, into thine hands
Michigan.
You are my son, but it's a hazardous trip you're taking. You're going to be tempted. You're going to be tested. You're going to be tried. And your keys of authority are going to be buried in the very depths of hell. And the only way you can collect your authority, you have to battle the demons of hell. But he said, that's all right. In burnt offerings and sacrifices, for sins I have had no pleasure. But upon it have thou prepared me. Then I said, Lord, I come. In the volume of the book, it's written of me to do thy will, O God. While the demons were rejoicing, Jesus was dying. Said, who